And I will again first start my presentation in Sanskrit, followed by its English translation. Sarvebhyo namo namaha. Adya parimeya sankhyanam vishaye eva mama prastutihi asti. Karanyor madhye parimeya sankhyah praptum ekasyah paddhatyah vishaye mama prastutihi. Dashama kakshayah ganita pustake asti eshah prashnah. Trichatur karanyor madhye ekam parimeya sankhyam labhantam. Find a rational number between root 3 and root 4. Vividha paddhatibhi vayam asya prashnasya uttaram praptum shaknumaha. Adya vayam ekam paddhatim drakshyamaha yatra rekha ganitasya prayogena using geometry vayam asya prashnasya uttaram prapsyamaha. Esha paddhatihi Shulba Sutreshu Tesham Vyakhyaneshu cha Varnita. Shad Vedangani Santi Yeshu Kalpa Shastram Ekam. Kalpa Shastreshu Shulba Sutrani Ekam Bhagam. Tani Ati Prachinani Apicha Ashta Shatadika Dvi Sahasra Varshani Purvam Virachitani. They were written around 2800 years ago. Shulba Sutrani Anekani, Yatha Baudhayana Sulbasutra, Apastamba Sulbasutra, Katyayana Sulbasutra, Ityadini. Shulba Sutreshu Eva Prasiddha Right Triangle Theorem, Api Varnitam. Shulba Sutreshu Jyamati Vishaye Anekani Sutrani Santi, Pradhanataya Tani Vedi Nirmanam, Construction of Vedic Altars, Varnayanti. Astu Adhuna Prashnasya Vishaye. Prathamam asmabhi jnatavyam yat katham rekhaganitam upayujya vayam idrashasya prashnasya uttaram praptum shaknumaha. Rekhaganitasya asya prashnasya cha sambandha kaha iti jnatavyaha. Sambandha ayameva. Sama chaturashrasya kshetram ya karani trik karoti sa Trikarani iti uchyate. Samachaturashrasya kshetram ya karani trikkaroti sa trikarani iti uchyate. Ataha anena drishtikonena asya prashnasya uttaram praptum asmabhyam kim avashyakam. Ekaha samachaturashraha avashyakaha yasya kshetram trichaturyoho madhye asti apicha asya karani eka parimeya sankhya bhutavya abhavitavya rational number bhavitavya. Yadi kshetram trichaturyoho madhye asti tada avashyameva karani trichatur karanyor madhye bhavishyati etadeva vayam ichchamah. Adhuna idrisham samachaturashram katham praptavyam iti drakshyamah. Uttara prapti paddhatehe sankshepaha ayameva. Prathamam vayam ekam trikshetra dirgha chaturashram svikarishyamaha tatpashchat tasya kartana lepanam kritva by cutting and pasting eka khanda sahita samachaturashrasya a square with a square hole tasya nirmanam karishyamaha. Asya samachaturashrasya kshetram kiyat. Asya kshetram tu varnayuta kshetrasya apicha khanda kshetrasya sankalanam asti. Varnayuta kshetram atra tri asti. Yadi khandasya kshetram ekataha nyunam bhavet tada brihat samachaturashrasya kshetram trichaturyoho madhye bhavishyati etadeva asmabhi abhishtam. Idanim dirgha chaturashraha katham khandasahita samachaturashraha karaniyaha iti drakshyamaha. Asti eshaha trikshetra dirgha chaturashraha yasya parshvamani length 3 tiryangmani breadth cha eka. Adhuna tiryangmanim karanim kritva asya tiryangmanim karanim kritva asmat eka kshetra samachaturashrasya vibhajanam karishyamaha. Asya tiryangmanim karanim kritva eka kshetra samachaturashrasya vibhajanam karishyamaha. Sampratam shesha bhagam aham naranga varnena darshayami. Shesham adhuna dvidha vibhajya. Shesham dvidha vibhajya etad bhagam. एतद् भागम् अस्य समचतुरश्रस्य उपरि स्थापयिष्यामः. शेषभागं द्विधा विभज्य एतद् अस्योपरि स्थापयिष्यामः. इदानीम् एषः तु एकखण्डसहितसमचतुरश्रः. एषः समचतुरश्रः एव अस्माभिः अभीष्टः वा? अस्य खण्डस्य क्षेत्रं कियत्? अस्य क्षेत्रं तु एकमस्ति. अस्य खण्डस्य क्षेत्रं तु एकम्. अतः बृहत् समचतुरश्रस्य क्षेत्रं चतुर्भवति. परम् अस्माभिः तु त्रिचतुर्योः मध्ये आवश्यकः. अतः किं करणीयम्? यदि वयं वर्णयुतक्षेत्रात् द्वौ पट्टौ कर्तयित्वा खण्डे लेपयिष्यामः तदा अवश्यमेव खण्डस्य क्षेत्रम् एकतः न्यूनं भविष्यति. अपि च सः समचतुरश्रः अस्माकं कृते योग्यः भविष्यति. परं कर्तनमपि सावधानपूर्वकं करणीयम्. एतयोः पट्टयोः क्षेत्रं खण्डस्य क्षेत्रात् अधिकमपि न भवितव्यम्. अतः यदि य अत्र चतुर्थं भवेत्, यदि य 1/4 भवेत्, तदा पट्टयोः क्षेत्रं 2 × 3 × y अस्ति. तद् एकं भविष्यति, यदस्माकं खण्डस्य क्षेत्रात् अधिकं नास्ति. अतः य चतुर्थं भवेत्. इदानीम् एतयोः कर्तनं कृत्वा खण्डे लेपयिष्यामः. इदानीं पश्यन्तु, पुनः एकः खण्डः दृश्यते. कुतः आगतः अयं खण्डः? कर्तनसमये एतद्भागं कर्तनसमये द्वयोः पट्टयोः आसीत्. यदा वयं प्रथमपट्टस्य कर्तनं कृतवन्तः, द्वितीयपट्टात् एतद्भागं निर्गतम्. एषः खण्डः एव अत्र दृश्यते. परम् अस्य खण्डस्य क्षेत्रं तु एकतः न्यूनमस्ति. अतः एषः समचतुरश्रः तु अस्माकं कृते योग्यः. अपि च अस्य बृहत् समचतुरश्रस्य करणि पादोनद्वि. अतः यतः एषः समचतुरश्रः अस्माकं कृते योग्यः, पादोनद्वि अस्य प्रश्नस्य एकम् उत्तरम्. परम् अनया पद्धत्या एतदपि सिद्धं भवति यत् न केवलं पादोनद्वि, परं पञ्चमोनद्वि, षष्टमोनद्वि, सप्तमोनद्वि, एतानि सर्वाणि 2-1/5, 2-1/6, 2-1/7 एतानि सर्वाणि अस्य प्रश्नस्य उत्तराणि. अस्तु, एषः प्रश्नः तु सुलभः प्रश्नः आसीत्. परं किञ्चित् कठिनप्रश्नस्य कृते अपि, उदाहरणकृते रूट् 17.5 अपि च रूट् 17.5001 एतयोर्मध्ये एकां परिमेयसङ्ख्यां लभन्ताम्. अस्य प्रश्नस्य उत्तरमपि अनया पद्धत्या अतिसौलभ्येन प्राप्तुं शक्यते. अस्तु, अस्याः पद्धतेः अन्यमपि एकं वैशिष्ट्यं पश्यन्तु. प्रथमं वयम् एकं त्रिक्षेत्रदीर्घचतुरश्रं स्वीकृतवन्तः. तस्य कर्तनलेपनं सर्वं कृत्वा एकखण्डसहितसमचतुरश्रस्य निर्माणं कृतवन्तः. तस्मात् द्वौ पट्टौ कर्तयित्वा तस्मिन् खण्डे लेपितवन्तः. किम् अभवत् तदा? पुनः एकः सखण्डसमचतुरश्रः जातः. इदानीं यदि अस्मात् समचतुरश्रात् द्वौ पट्टौ कर्तयित्वा अस्मिन् खण्डे लेपयिष्यामः, किं भविष्यति? पुनः एकः सखण्डसमचतुरश्रः भविष्यति. अनेन किं दर्शितम्? एतत्तु अनन्तं चलिष्यति. अपि च प्रत्येककर्तनात् नूतनखण्डस्य क्षेत्रं न्यूनं जायते. अपि च प्रत्येककर्तनात् नूतनसमचतुरश्रस्य अश्रः त्रिकरणी समीपे आगच्छति. अनया पद्धत्या एव सम्भवतः शुल्बकारः शुल्बसूत्रेषु द्विकरणीविषये, आन् द राशनल् अप्राक्सिमेशन् आफ् रूट् 2, तस्मिन् विषये एतत् सूत्रं विरचितवान्. एतत् बौधायनशुल्बसूत्रात् सूत्रं 2.12 अस्ति. अत्र उक्तं प्रमाणं तृतीयेन वर्धयेत् ತಚ್ಚತುರ್ಥೇನ ಆತ್ಮಚತುಸ್ತ್ರಿಂಶೇನ ಊನೇನ ಸವಿಶೇಷ ಇತಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ 1 + 1/3 + 1/3 × 4 − 1/3 × 4 × 34. ಧನ್ಯವಾದ. I will now go through this quickly in English. So today's topic deals with a method based on the Sulbasutras, which can be used to find rational numbers between surds. So in our class 10 mathematics book, we come across this question. Find a rational number between root 3 and root 4. Now there are various methods through which one can find the answer to this problem. Today we will see a method involving geometry, which can be used to find the answer to this problem. This method is based on the Sulbasutras and its commentaries. There are 6 Vedangas, among which the Kalpa Shastram is one. The Sulbasutras are a part of this Kalpa Shastram. These are ancient texts which were written around 2800 years ago. There are many Sulbasutras, including Baudhayana Sulbasutra, Apastamba Sulbasutra, Katyayana Sulbasutra, etc. It is in the Sulbasutras where the famous right triangle theorem is also described. The Sulbasutras contain many sutras related to geometry, and they primarily deal with the construction of Vedic altars. Okay, so going back to the question, first, we shall find out what is the relation between geometry and this question. How can we use geometry to find the solution to such a problem? Here is the connection. Root 3 is the side of a square whose area is 3 square units. Root 3 is the side of a square whose area is 3 square units. So from this viewpoint, for our question, what do we require? We require a square whose area lies between 3 and 4 and whose side is a rational number. So if the area lies between 3 and 4, then definitely the side of that square will lie between root 3 and root 4, and this is what we want. So now let us see how to get such a square. So this is the essence of the method we are going to see. We shall first consider a rectangle of area 3 square units, and by cutting and pasting, convert it into a square with a square hole. Now the area of this big square is the area of the colored portion plus the area of the hole. In this case, the area of the colored portion is 3. So if the area of the hole is less than 1, then the area of the big square ABCD will be between 3 and 4. And this is what we require. So now let us see how to convert a rectangle into a square with a square hole. So consider a rectangle of area 3 square units having length 3 units and breadth 1. From this rectangle, we shall cut out a square of side 1 unit. Now the remaining area has been shown in orange. So we will now divide the remaining area into two parts. So divide the remaining area into two parts and place this the part on the right hand side above the square we just cut out. So I place this part on top of the square. Now this is actually a square with a square hole. Now is this the desired square we are looking for? Since the area of the hole in this case is equal to 1 square unit, the area of the big square comes to be 4 square units. But we require a square of area between 3 and 4. So what can we do? From the colored portion of this square, if we cut out two strips, and paste it inside the hole, then definitely the area of the hole will be less than 1. And the resultant square will satisfy all the conditions we require. But the cutting too has to be done carefully. The area of the two strips should not exceed the area of the hole. So in this case, if we consider if B is 1 by 4, then the area of the two strips put together is 2 into length 2 into 1 by 4, which comes out to be 1, which is not greater than the area of our whole. So let B be 1 by 4. So now we will cut the strips and paste it inside this hole. Now we find the presence of yet another hole in this new square. Where did this hole come from? Just before cutting, this particular part was in both the strips. So the hole created after cutting the first strip is the hole we now see here. Now, is this square satisfying all the conditions we require? Since the hole's area is less than 1 and the side of this, the side of the big square, which is 2 minus 1 by 4, is a rational number, this square satisfies our conditions, and therefore 2 minus 1 by 4 is an answer to this question. That is, 2 minus 1 by 4 is a rational number which lies between root 3 and root 4. Now, from this method also, it is evident that not just 2 minus 1 by 4, but from this 2 minus 1 by 5, 2 minus 1 by 6, 2 minus 1 by 7, and so on, all of these are answers to this problem. So the question we considered was a simple one, but even for a slightly difficult problem, like, for example, find a rational number between root 17.5 and root 17.5001. The answer to even such problems can be easily found using this method. Okay, so here is another interesting feature of this method. See, we first considered a rectangle of area 3 square units and by cutting and pasting, converted it into a square with a square hole. We then cut out two strips from the colored portion of that square and pasted it in its hole. What was the result? We ended up with another square, we ended up again with a square hole. Now, the area of this new hole was less than the area of the previous hole. Now, from this square, if we again cut out two strips and paste it in its hole, what will be the result? We will again end up with yet another square with a square hole. So, what does this show? This process will go on and on, and with each successive step, the area of the hole becomes smaller and smaller, and the side of the new square comes closer and closer to root 3. It is probably using a method like this that the Shulbakara in the Sulbasutras has given us the sutra for the rational approximation of root 2. So this is the sutra from the Baudhayana Sulbasutras. It is Soothram 2.12. It says, Pramanam Tritiyena Vardhayet Tachaturthena Atma Chatustrimshena Unena Savisheshaha. That is, root 2 is approximately 1 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 into 4 minus 1 by 3 into 4 into 34. Thank you.